So we still have a high priest. And his name is?
Jesus.
And his priesthood is better than the Old Testament and the Levitical priesthood. And here it talks directly about how they receive tithes and why he should be able to receive tithes. Y'all got it? Okay. Now, other passages in the writings of Jesus that talk about this, I won't go into, are very interesting, though. I'll just allude to them for you. Jesus personally rebukes the Pharisees and says this, you guys, this is a Jackson translation, you think you're hotshots because you give a tithe. But you have forgotten the weightier things of the law. Anybody ever heard that? You forgot mercy and judgment. That goes back to what we were talking about last week, and we're going to go back there in a moment. It goes back to the book of Malachi that we talked about last week, which whole goal was that we are to bring a offering in righteousness. Malachi chapter 2 told us that we are to have the sons of Levi purified, and that they were to bring an offering in righteousness, that the coming Messiah, who is Jesus, would be like a refiner's fire and a fuller's soap. Anybody ever hear that? Yeah. Refiner's fire is a fire that takes metal and heats it up and purifies it. So a refiner takes metal and they bring it to a certain boiling point and you scrape off all the impurities. And you use some kind of mold, if you would. And sometimes you might use a certain kind of filter or a metal filter, or if you are making aircraft parts today, you might have a ceramic filter that would be used to make sure all the impurities are taken out of that metal so that when the part was cast, it would look and function just the way it should. Jesus is supposed to be that one that heats things up in our lives. And in the middle of that heat, scrapes away everything that's not like God in your life. You know, there's some stuff we can't even see that's there under normal temperature. But you let a little pressure get up on you. There it goes.